anyway, it's been a fantastic rise of the Prince George comedy community, and I would like to, it can almost be attributed to one person who moved back to town about 5 or 6 years ago, and has really been fostering and mentoring the young comics that you've seen tonight. And he's a very funny guy, and I think you've probably seen him before, but he's always always very entertaining, and like I said, a big part of the comedy community. So let's bring him up here, Mr. Brian Majore.
So I was talking to my girlfriend. She asked me, she goes, why do guys cheat on their girlfriends even when they already have a good woman at home? And I accidentally laughed in her face and I said, I think you're a good woman. She would ask me questions like that all the time, loaded questions, questions I couldn't possibly answer. Like she asked me this one time, are all guys cheaters? Like how am I supposed to answer that? If I say yes, that puts me in with all guys. And if I say no, I would be lying. Don't make me lie to you. It's bad enough I'm cheating on you. So my girlfriend came back from the fingernail place. I don't know what it's But she's all excited. You know, she's showing me her fingernails. She's like, aren't they pretty with all the stars and the moons? And I couldn't even fake interest. So finally I asked her, I said, what did that cost you? I think she said like $40 or something like that. Which kind of caught my attention. And I asked her, like, how can you pay that much? Something like that. She's like, oh, it's just a little thing that us girls do for ourselves. I'm like, really? That's something you do for yourself. Why the fuck did you show me every time you get it done? I mean, the only time I ever notice your fingernails is when they wrap around my cock. And even then, they're moving so fast, so I'm in the shower, my girlfriend starts smacking my dick around. Back in. And she says to me, she goes, you know, if I had a big dick like yours, I'd be up trying to fuck every girl and get my hands on. Then like a month later, she had the nerve to get mad at me, because that's exactly what I did. Like, don't get mad at me for something you yourself would do. Isn't that a bit hypocritical? Is that the definition of hypocrite? It is. So I broke up with my girlfriend. I broke up with my girlfriend because I lost respect for her. And I lost respect for her because she saved me even after she found out I cheated on her. And I can't do something like that. Like, there was some balls, baby Jesus. You know how she found out I cheated on her? She went through my phone. Like, how am I supposed to trust her with my dick in her mouth or something like that? She grabbed my phone to me this one time. She's like, why is this locked? Are you trying to hide something from me? And I found it hard to lie to her, you know, maybe because she was pretty funny. But the message she found when she went through my phone was from a girl who said, thank you for the great time last night. That can mean anything. But, anyway, before you guys get all judgy on me, let me ask you a question. If you switched your phone with your girlfriend or boyfriend for the day, would you still be together at the end of the day? All the girls are like, yeah. And all the guys are like, shut the fuck up, dude. Hi, and I was back home this one time on the res, and I was with my mother, and I saw this really attractive girl. I was like, oh, mom, who's that? She paused a little bit. She said, oh, that's your cousin. I was like, oh. And I saw another attractive girl. I said, oh, mom, who's that? She said, that's your cousin. Then I found out later she was lying to me. She was just trying to keep me away from these girls. So when the next time it happened, I called her on it. I saw this other attractive man girl, I was like, oh, mom, who's that? I said, It's my cousin.
No,
you can't be. You can't all be my cousin. She's like, all right. She's not your cousin. Stay away from her. She's nothing but trouble. She'll go with anyone. My mom went from a cockblocker to the best wingman ever. And I'll make Brian Major, thank you for listening.